God bless you guys for joining me here at Harvest Hill Church and Harvest Hill Studios here in the city of Dallas. I am Pastor Charles Ellis. We're going to be talking about today dealing with the Father which is in heaven. I know today is the day that we all celebrate Father's Day, and that's a great thing. Some of us look at Father's Day in such a way, yeah, he did take care of his child, he didn't take care of his child, but let's hold on, let's focus, let's not get to that point now. Let's talk about how the Father in heaven looked over us and cared for both of us, both men and women. To the opportunity he stole such a great love upon us to the point that we couldn't imagine or understand. We're going to the book of 1 John over in chapter 3. We're talking about the power of the bestowed love of the Father that he put upon us as being men and women God. If we all have the opportunity to receive the right to the tree of life. I know today is Father's Day and happy Father's Day to all the fathers. Now, some actually have not fathers in the household, but the mother gets a lot of credibility, a lot of work. This is one of the things we're going to talk about in terms of not just putting it in a biased way, saying one thing more better than the other. I want to talk about the Father in heaven. He talks about the power that he bestowed upon us, what great power he bestowed upon us as being man and woman of God. As we prepare ourselves to get ready for the service this morning, as I said before, it's always a pleasure for you guys to join me here at Harvest Light Church and Harvest Light Church. If we are going live, this is a live segment. You can catch us on videotape recording on any of the social network stations. For those who want to listen to the station, if we listen, those who want to listen in on the station as of right now, excuse me for that interruption, you can go to www.spreaker.com. Go to spreaker.com. You want to load in the app. That app is going to be spreaker.com, as I said before. You want to put it in what we call the search bar, Charles Ellis. If you go into the search bar, you can actually come into either one of the shows. As a matter of fact, the show is going on right now. We got Donnie McCurtain playing in the background. We're going to let him go forth. He's talking about the power of God and what God has done for him. Grace he bestowed upon each and every one of us. But I don't want to sound redundant during the course of the time of this particular teaching that we're doing, because we want you to understand and realize that there's a great work that God got in each and every one of us. We've been parents, we've been men and women of God who represent his children here on earth. And so we want to let you guys know it's always an opportunity, always a pleasure for you guys to be with me here at Harvest New Life Church and Harvest New Life Studios. Now we're in the studio today. Most of you guys will be coming to our locations. We're going to be changing our locations because we're getting a little full at the locations we have. For those who don't know about our services, the services take place every second and fourth Sunday. Every first and third Sunday, we're actually here in the studio as our other studio that we're building to get things together. It's under completion. And those of you who come back and set in on the studio, just give me an invitation. Just give me a heads-up notice. Let me know you're going to be coming. And we can have you drop to come in. On the regular studio, we can say give you a head up notice because you tend to walk into the studio because it's a secure door. And if you don't get in at a certain time, you won't be able to come in because the taping is starting. And we don't want you to walk in during the course of the time the taping is going and be kind of an interruption to the service. But enough on that. For those who want to know more about us at harvestlifechurch.com, you can go to the website and see the locations where we are. And where we have some of the meetings, both here in the studio and both here at our physical location. So we want to get into the Word this morning. We want to thank God, first of all, for this opportunity just to be with you guys on the line. It's not all the time you guys get a chance to see me physically. We're going to do a lot of broadcasting, audio broadcasting. And I think that's a good way to get the Word out because we get a lot of cell phones or iPads. But most of the young people are actually holding these days. You know, this is what we're trying to get to the young people. Not saying forsaking the old, but want to get to the young people because we want them to hear the Word of God and hear what he's doing in the lives of them and the gift he's paid them to help them move forward to the power he's bestowed upon them. You hear me talk about Jeremiah 1:5 all the time, how God genetically engineered and designed us to have gift before in our mother's womb, before we came through our mother's womb. And coming forth, he created us to have a unfail safe system that we can't fail. And we go to him asking whatever we need. In the name of you. Talk a little too much. We're going to get into this word this morning. Let's bow our heads and pray. Father God, we thank you. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, for giving us this opportunity to come before your throne once again to bring forth your word in the season of obedience. Father God, that's an opportunity that we never can take for granted. Father God, let me be the conduit as I go into the word on this morning, and let it be revealed through the Spirit. that I believe, Father God, there's no weapon formed against the word, and nothing designed and engineered against it shall prosper, and nothing shall be able to stand. Father God, we thank you for this opportunity. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I pray, Lord, amen. That's it. Once you have Father, to all the fathers out there in fatherland, and I want you to know this is a great day for each and every one of you. That God allowed you to be able to be living, see what I would say, the seed that was sowed in the earth, that it may bring forth more fruit. But it's a lot of discrepancy and a lot of things that we have between families and the man and the child and the father. But we want you to put that aside. And want you to try to move with some revelation to going forward. You know, sometimes the enemy, not sometimes, but most times the enemy comes in, and the first thing he want to do is to divide the family. That's his job. That's his MO, to put much division on the individual that they can take the very thing that God brought into the earth to replenish the earth, and to separate it, that it may be lost. The word of God tells us over in the book of 1 John. I'm going to turn our Bibles over to 1 John. Got my little tattletale sheet here, some of my notes. Got my Bible sitting right here. I want to go over to the book of 1 John. I hope you guys can hear me pretty good, because I got my audio system going, and plus I got you guys going right here, and I got a few people sitting here with me, and that's fine. That's no problem. I've never been afraid about doing the work I'm doing, believe me. You know, either you're going to receive it, you're not going to receive it. I don't want to put it so like that in a way it sounds negative, but the word of God has got to go forth. I mean, regardless whether you hear it or not, it's got to go forth. I'm designed to bring a conduit. I'm designed to bring the word, whether you turn it up or whether you turn it off. This is what I'm designed to do. So I said, I have to do the work that God's called me to do. In the book of 1 John, over in chapter 3, it starts off with a very powerful statement about, it said, behold, what manner of love the Father has bestowed upon us, that we should not be called children of God. Now let's look at that again. What manner of love the Father, who's in heaven, has bestowed on us, that we should not be called children of God. I want to focus there just for a minute, not too long, but I want you to understand something. He said, what manner of love he has, the creator, the one who engineered us and created us, the one who actually brought us out before the foundations of the world, what manner he loves. Now, we got a lot of discrepancy in love about different fathers, different mothers in the world today, and falls on what we call the marriage system in the world. But the Father said he bestowed a love upon you that's far more greater than you and I can imagine to even understand. I believe I'm speaking this morning, because we got to be able to set our differences to the side on a day like today and recognize who's really the Father in our lives. If it wasn't for the Father in heaven, that would never have been a Mary Magdalene. If it wasn't for the Father in heaven, that never would have been an Adam. So in the process of all those things taken forth, we got to understand that he was the first father of all, and he's the father of all in all. And the word of God declares that, even we think about it, not going back to the scripture, the word says, you know, John 3:16, that God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that we all may have the right to the tree of life. So that's a very powerful statement there, that he gave up his only son, that we may have this opportunity now. Not to bicker, not to fling, not to fight, not to have arguments among one another, but come with the subtlety to understand that if it wasn't for God, we never would have came together anyway. Whether your position with your family is at a separating point right now, and you're working in your own heart to try to get it right, to get it back together, knowing that the time you spent with that individual was well time spent. Because if it wasn't, man, the children wouldn't have been here. So let's look at that in a different way. There are always going to be hills and peaks and valleys in relationships. We understand that. But to be able to come together to be as one and understand and realize that God's got a plan for each and every one of our lives. And what the enemy comes in, he tries to come in and destroy that. His job is to tear it apart, to make you feel opposite of what God designed and engineered you to be and your children to be in the seed that's coming from your children. So the word of God makes it, and he takes it off what we call the physical system. He puts it in the spiritual system. Because now the creator is saying here, what manner of love the Father who's in heaven, has bestowed on us, that we should be called children of God. Therefore, the world does not know us because it did not know him. Now, that's what he's wanting to do. He's wanting to make us feel so opposite of what he designed us to be and created us to be. So, you know, we talk about in the book of Jeremiah 29:11. That's my wife's favorite verse. He talks about Jeremiah 29. He talks about process. For I only now know the thoughts of the plans that I got for you. They are good and not of evil. Now, if God's got an expected future for me and you and all that we do, then there's got to be something that's going to come in and hinder that future. Because God declares and creates, he's not a God that he should lie. and not a son of any man that he should have to repent. He's been given a command to bless, and he cannot reverse it. Let's think about the process when we talk about that, being fathers and mothers. We come together sometime, and there's discrepancies between the father, discrepancies between the mother, but we got to understand what came out of that relationship is more incredible than we can imagine even think of. Whenever there's a midst of a relationship that's going on between a husband and a wife, or a boyfriend and a girlfriend, whatever it may be, we all got to follow the golden rule of commands that we all want to wait on our wives, but all of us hadn't really obeyed that rule as of right now. I can raise my hand on that. Everybody got to be free about that, because God says you got to really wait on your mate. And when you come together, you don't want to come together in such a way that it'll be a shacking thing. In other words, you want to wait until that right woman, that right man is there for you, and you want to be able to hold them cherishable, because that's what's going to bring forth your seed. Now, there's some things that happen in people's life, and I honestly can't speak out on anyone, and I don't think any man is in the pulpit, even though that they're in a situation where they didn't have these things going on in their life, still can say that they're better than any other father that's out there. We all got fathers, but the enemy has come in. He has creeped in, as the word of God said. And he's came in, and he's poured diversity in the midst of us as being man and woman of God. His job was to drive a wedge between relationship. But the Father declares in the creed that he bestowed a great love upon us, that he bestowed a great love upon us, that to the point that we should be called children of God. We are children of God. Now, I'm going somewhere. Don't you guys stay with me here. Don't just stay with me here. The divine nature is manifested in children. Let's look at John 1 and 18. Let's look at John 1 and 18. My children, let not love in the world or the tongue, but in deeds, in truth. Now, notice what he says out there. My children, let us not love in words or tongue, but in deeds and truth. It's not so much that we can just speak it all the time. We got to declare it in how we carry ourselves as being man and woman of God. If we go back to the verse, chapter 3 and John 1, 1 John 1 and 3, he says, what manner of love the Father has bestowed upon us as being children of God. Therefore, the world does not know us. For the world does not know him. The Lord does not know him because it does not know him. The world does not know me because it does not know him. Let me rephrase that, because I want to get that right here. It says, what manner of love the Father has bestowed upon us has been children of God. Therefore, the world does not know us because it did not know him. Now, that speaks volume. When we come into relationships, we come into the covenants with God, which is called the marriage. The Bible said, whatever you put together, let no man separate, because that's a covenant of God. When that covenant comes together, are there going to be peaks and valleys? You better bet you. You know, it's going to be peaks and valleys in that relationship. But the biggest thing of all, we got to understand the love, how God really designed us this day to be one to come together. See, if it wasn't for the love he put upon us, and even though we was born out of marriage, some of us born out of marriage, wedlock, whatever it may be, and the lives that we had got out there and had fun, and a child was developed. But that was actually the sovereignty of God to bring forth that child. And not only as we look at it in disobedience, we look at it as being reverence to God in such a way that God really allowed that to come forth. So a child is never a mistake. It's just when he gets in the relationship between you and that woman and calls that division to take place. And that's what he want to do. He want that child to be able to go out there and be raised in such a way that he'll find the streets better than he'll find the Lord. This is why the word of God says, train a child up in the way he should go, and he would not depart from the path once he grows older. Now, when I say that, I got to make sure I'm saying it in the right way. Now, when there's a relationship between a man and a woman that takes place and is outside holy matrimony, don't let that be a division to be able to drive just your part to a point that we can just go out and continue to keep on multiplying out there in the streets and just sowing seed, in other words, until we come to the point where we feel that we can't sow no more seeds, and then the system gets hold to us, and then we can't afford to do anything anymore, and then all of a sudden we got division between the child and the father and the mother. And when it comes down to days like this, well, he's not a father. Well, he's not a mother. Well, I can say the same thing about every one of us. You know, God never looked at you about that. He never looked at you in that matter. He thought you wasn't a child, that you didn't belong to him. He loved you. The word of God said he so loved you that he gave his only begotten son. This is what God done for me and you. He loved you that he gave his only begotten son. As he gave his only begotten son, we will all have the right to that tree of life. What is the tree of life? To be able to grow fruitfully with the joy, the peace, the love, to realize and understand that God has designed us to bring forth more fruit in the earth. that we may realize and understand that the plan God has for us supersedes far beyond more than we can imagine, even understand. I want to make sure I'm not stumbling on my words here, because a lot of times you guys don't get a chance to see me on the segment. You're in a lot.